Karen Citizen. Jimmy Dugan from Crowley. Travis Huckabee from Eunice. Kendra Johnson from Eunice. Allie Kelly from Eunice. Mia Kirsch from Crowley. Barry Lemaire from Gaydon. Amanda Lucero from Basil. Shayla Mott from Church Point. Tracy Matthews from Jenny's. Candace Plaisance from Rain. Shayna Roach from Midland. Shanquilla Rito from Rain. Kelly So from Egan. Tori Strotter from Iota. And Connie Traum from Esterwood. Would you please stand for the invocation by Brother Jared?
I want to say a big congratulations to each one of these graduates, and I know that each one of you are very proud of graduates. For it's a big accomplishment for a family member and a mother and a father and a husband and wives and children. It's a big relief because you know that they finally accomplished what their eyes been set for. Their goals is accomplished. So we say congratulations to each and every one. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this wonderful group, God. You know your hand is upon them, and we ask, God, that you will lead them and guide them every step of the way of their life, God. We pray that you will open the right doors for them. Place them, Lord, where you want them to be. And Father, give them a heart for these men and women that are hurting. And Father, that you will give them the strength to continue to go on each and every day. And God, when times get tough and times get rough, I pray, God, that you will shower them and bathe them with your grace, oh God. Reach down your hand from heaven and strengthen them every step of the way. God, that they'll be a lighthouse where you place them at. That they'll be full of joy and full of peace and full of happiness and full of kindness. God, that they will speak forth the words that will be comforting to those that they are reaching their hands to. Bless them, God, in their endeavors, and bless them indeed. Strengthen them today, and from this day forth, lead them, guide them. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. God bless you.
Good evening. My name is Sandy Bollinger, and I'm the one of the instructors for the practical nursing class, and I'm the department head. I would like to welcome everyone to SLCC Acadian Campus pinning ceremony for the practical nursing class 47. I know that without the love and support of family and friends, these graduates would have had a much more difficult time completing. So I would like to thank all of you in behalf of the graduates. The nursing curriculum is rigorous. Therefore, it took time, patience, and dedication for these nurses to complete. There was much blood, sweat, and tears put into this. However, they persevered. I have been teaching for many years, and I'm still amazed at the transformation that takes place with these students. They start out nervous, not knowing what to do or expect, and by the time they complete, they're confident and anxious for the next experience. As an instructor, I am their teacher, and all other instructors, as well as myself, do the best we can to instill our knowledge and experience into the future nurses. I'm very proud of all of them. They have had several traumas throughout this time. However, they continued forward. I can now say after boards, they are my peers, and I hope they have the same satisfaction I have had as a nurse in this society. Thank you all, and thank you to the students for giving me the opportunity to help you to reach your dream.
To you that I just like. like, because it brings me back to where I was when I first became a nurse. And anyone who knows me can tell you that I've always wanted to be a nurse since I was a little girl. I don't know why, really. I think maybe my dad influenced that in some way, but I cannot imagine myself ever doing anything else other than being a nurse. If someone took that away from me, I could tell you that I would probably fall apart and just be lost, because it's so much a part of who I am and what I do. And they say that you should not let your job take over your life, but it's very hard to not bring it home with you when you are a nurse, because you bring home all of your patients' problems, all of their heartaches. You really take on responsibility for so many things when you're a nurse. So I want to read this to y'all. Nancy never wears white anymore, especially not pantyhose. White shows all the stains, the blood, the betadine splashes, pen ink, baby formula, spit up, and middle stains too. White signifies for her the early years when Nancy had to starch and iron before her 7 p.m. shift. She could never understand why it mattered to her sleeping patients that her nails were trimmed and her white shoes were polished and unscuffed. The color never made sense either, not in this field of work, which is messy and at times downright dirty. Of course, it wasn't really for the patients. White is a symbol of purity, reverence, and service. Now the only time you really see nurses dressed in white are on Halloween, in adult videos, or when the nursing students come to the hospital. These days, Nancy wears pastels with purple plastic gardening clogs. She washes them warm, dry high, and they're wrinkle-free. She cleans the spill off her shoes with alcohol wipes. And you know, it's really funny because seriously, the only time we see white is when you guys come into the hospital. And it just brings me back to where I used to be, because when I was in nursing school, I wore a dress and pantyhose. When I first became a nurse, I still wore a dress because I chose to, not because I had to. And that blows most of my peers at work away, that I actually chose to wear a dress. I thought it looked neat, and I thought it looked professional. And it was just the image that I always had, that I was going to be in a white dress with my white pantyhose and my white sash shoes. And no one wears that anymore. A couple of years ago for Nurses' Day, the department heads at the hospital got together, and we dressed in our whites, our dresses, and our pantyhose, and our caps, and all of those things for Nurses' Day. And I'm telling y'all, it was the biggest hit. We didn't tell anybody we were doing it. When we got to work, the doctors were just, oh my God, this is so much fun. They, you know, the older doctors could not even believe it. But, you know, I said, don't get any ideas, because we're not wearing this every day. It's too hard to keep it clean. Anyway, boy, the profession has certainly changed as much as the color of the uniforms that we wear to work, because when I became a nurse, it was so much about just taking care of patients. And now the responsibilities of a nurse are so huge. You know, the first nurses were mostly nuns, or they were in the military. Now you have nurses, and they were all women. So now you have nurses from all walks of life, all genders. And at this point, I think our profession is at a 1-to-19 male-to-female ratio. That number has changed so much over the years. So keep those guys coming in, because they make such excellent nurses, and they do such a good job taking care of the patients. Yeah, I think the best definition of a nurse today is that you are an artist and you are a scientist. You know, there are so many roles that you will take on in a day. It's a very highly diversified profession. Nurses carry a very ambiguous status. The training period is long, the requirements are high, the responsibilities are great. You're actually responsible for people's lives. Yet the rewards and the prestige are generally low. You are required to have a mastery of complicated skills, extensive knowledge and competency, and you carry a heavy responsibility. A few other expectations of the modern nurse are that you have knowledge of mental and physical sciences, sensitivity to applications of enormous physical signs and symptoms, skill in the use of numerous complicated instruments and techniques, and personal attributes that you must possess also include tact, sensitivity, kindness, cheerfulness, compassion, generosity, initiative, warmth, and a thorough knowledge of the total organization in which you work, policy and procedures. So I'm not trying to put any pressure on you, but I'm still not done. You're also expected to be an economist, rationing scarce commodities. And I know that you probably feel that in our hospital. You know, we're small, and we have to watch every penny because we need every resource we have to take care of patients. You are also expected to be a computer nerd, a janitor, a barber, a peacekeeper, a problem solver, and most of all, a miracle worker. So where do you find people that are willing to do this job? Well, they're right here in this room, and I'm very proud of each and every one of you. I know this has been a very tough journey. I commend you for all of the sleepless nights. I know you probably did it with 1,000 other things on your schedule that you were juggling, and everything in your life doesn't happen around your school schedule. So sometimes your kids are sick, you're sick, and tragedy happens. And you guys even dealt with the loss of a classmate, and I think that probably would be one of the most difficult things you guys had to get through as a class. And I commend all of you, and I respect the way that you all handled it with grace in class. Anyway, I want to tell you congratulations. I'm looking forward to working with you, and it's been a pleasure. Thank y'all so much, and congratulations. I hope you get to do everything your heart desires in your nursing career, and I hope you love it and enjoy it as much as I have mine.
I'm going to read to you the meaning of the nurse's pen. In my hand, I hold a nurse's pen, which today has become a symbol that nurses wear as part of the nurse's uniform. Florence Nightingale was the first to receive one. It was presented to her in 1855 by Queen Victoria as a mark of esteem and gratitude for her devotion toward Queen's soldiers during the Crimean War of 1854. The pen, designed by Queen Victoria's husband, Prince Albert, was gold with a St. George cross in red enamel, surrounded by a diamond crown. It bore the name Crimea, and blessed are the merciful. We do not know what this pen meant to Miss Nightingale, but we know what it means to us. It does not have a diamond crown, and it is not made of gold. But we wear it with pride and always do our best to deserve the right to wear it. And I'm also going to read the meaning of the lamp. Florence Nightingale left for Crimea, taking with her 38 self-proclaimed nurses of limited experience, 24 of whom were nuns. On arrival, they found overcrowded, filthy hospitals with no beds, no furniture, no eating utensils, no medical supplies, no blankets, no soap, no linens, and no lamps. Wounded soldiers lay on the floor in their battle uniforms in filth. Nightingale took charge. Using the supplies she brought and raising funds, She purchased supplies that doctors couldn't obtain for the Army. She hired people to clean up the hospitals and established laundries to wash linens and uniforms and prepare nutritious meals. She believed that the best nurses were those of good character, experienced, a sense of calling, and were well trained to meet the physical needs of patients. The barracks, a 4-mile labyrinth of cots, meant for 1,700 patients, packed in 3,000 to 4,000 patients. She didn't want her nurses on the wards after dark and could often be seen after hours making additional rounds with her lamp to check on patients. The soldiers finally referred to her as Birdie. These extra efforts earned her the title, the Lady with the Lamp. Thank you.
For all the money you gave me to buy school supplies, gas, and food. To Allison, I would like to thank you for helping me study my flashcards, even though you couldn't pronounce the words. To my family, friends, and church members, I would like to thank you for all the support and prayers. To my instructors, thank you for the knowledge you have instilled in me to pass this program. To Quilla and Tracy, I'm going to miss clowning and laughing with you guys. To class 47, it was a bumpy road, but we made it. Good luck to all of you, and remember, with God, all things are possible. Jenny Dugan, first and foremost, I want to thank my mom. I couldn't have done this without you. You're the only reason I had the opportunity to start and finish this program. You always encouraged me to do the best I could with my life, and you made sacrifices to see it happen. I'm extremely grateful for all the help and support you've given me over the past 2 years, and I will never forget it. Secondly, I want to thank Miss Sandra. In the first semester, I was struggling to keep up, and I came very close to quitting. You both, however, encouraged me to stay. If it wasn't for that, I would have quit and I would not be here today. I greatly appreciate that you both believed in me. Finally, I want to thank my classmates. You've been through some good times and some bad times that I will always remember. Y'all are always supportive and accepting, and I wouldn't have chosen another group of people to go through this with. I know you will all make good nurses, and I hope you all have great and successful lives in the coming years. Travis Huckabee. Through all the stress of this last year and a half, there are many people to share the burdens with me. This is a thank you to them. First, thanks to the most two important and main motivators in my life, Raleigh, my beautiful daughter, and Elizabeth, the love of my life. Y'all gave me what was needed to make it through the many hours and days sacrificed. I love both of you beyond words. I can now play Candyland with you, Raleigh. Thanks to Charlotte, my mother, for spoiling my daughter during my many pages of studying and times of snoozing, and for giving me the support I desperately needed. Then there's Carla and Chris, my parent-in-laws. Thanks for the love, support, and jokes through this class. A super thank you to my father, James, for helping with just about everything. Without you, I wouldn't be here. A very special thanks to my grandpa, Silton, for always being available to help when I needed to fix something during those times of tight budgets. Thanks, Papa. I'd like to also give thanks to you, Hunter, Ms. Deborah, Tiny, Adrian, Nick, Michael, Cecile, my fellow workers, administrators, classmates, Beacon Nachos, instructors, Mrs. Sandra Bollinger, Cynthia McGinn, Renita Lede, Sandra Mock, and my many friends who gave me encouragement. Kendra Johnson. Kendra Johnson would like to give a great thanks and appreciation to her family and friends for their unconditional support and love throughout her challenging time of nursing school. Thank you, Mom, for the assistance and help with my two boys, helping with day-to-day living activities, financial support, emotional support, for listening to all my venting and frustrations when I wanted to give up. Thank you, Dad, also for supporting me financially and for all your motivational speeches. I would like to thank my boys for understanding my situation. My sister and Aunt Earth for all their help, my teachers, and would also like to thank my best friend, study buddy, Simone, for helping me out with everything. I couldn't have completed this journey without you all. It's been a blessing, and I love you all. Thank you once again. Allie Kelly. Without God, nothing is possible. We have Him to thank for the blessings and success we accomplished in the past 18 months. I am blessed with my husband, Lucas Kelly, who is very supportive, and I could not have gotten through this without him to lean on. I love you very much and thank you from the bottom of my heart for helping me through all of the tough times and not letting me give up. I know it was hard on you having to work and support us while I was in school, but you did it with a smile on your face, and I hope you know how much I appreciate that. We have a beautiful son, Carter, who is my biggest motivation and always makes me laugh through all the stressful times. Together, we have a huge family, all of whom were very supportive. I love all of my siblings and parents very much and thankful for their encouragement. Mom, Kenny, Dad, Crystal, you always have encouraging words, and you are all willing to help in any way possible, and I couldn't have asked for more. To my in-laws, Kimberly and Stan Lower, I couldn't have met more supportive and encouraging people than you two. At times you believed in me more than I believed in myself, and failing was never an option. Thank you for all of your support, emotionally, financially, and even sometimes mentally. Mrs. Sandy, Miss Renita, Miss Mock, Miss Nell, thank you all for the time and energy you put into molding each and every one of us into nurses. You are all great instructors, and I am very thankful for that. Like my mother-in-law says, this was only a season of our lives, and now I think we can all say with pride that we made it through and are ready to move on to the next season. Mia Kirsch. This is by far the hardest thing I have ever had to write. There are so many things I would like to say as well. So many people that I would like to thank. But I would like to take the opportunity to point out the three most important people in my life, my kids. The smallest people that have made the largest impact on me. They are the three people that had it the hardest in my journey through school. and for that I owe them my life. They are the ones that never questioned me or had a harsh word to say. They loved me, they encouraged me, and showed affection to me no matter what the circumstances. They will have my unconditional love and appreciation forever. Jaden, thank you for loving me unconditionally. And thank you for having the patience when having to pick up my slack with your brothers. You are a great sister to them. Thank you for wiping away my tears in moments of trials and tribulations. You always seem to turn my frown upside down. You have, over time, made me question some of the decisions that I make for my life. I want more than anything for you to grow and know that I have fought to give you the best life possible. You have been pushed to the side during this time of my schooling, and with the new babies, you always manage to still smile. You touch my heart in ways that you will never understand, and for that, you will always be my special little girl. I love you. Cameron, being 7 months pregnant for you when I began my semester of school, I knew I would be in for a challenge. From the moment I laid eyes on you, I fell in love. You were, at that moment, my biggest motivation to finish school. I wanted to be home with you. I wanted to share every moment of your life with you. Unfortunately, I may have missed some of those moments, but you were always on my mind. You motivated me to get through every day. When I wanted to give up, your bright blue eyes and crooked little smile would flash in my mind, giving me the strength and courage to get through every day, reminding me that I was only doing this for a short time and that I was doing it for you. Your kisses, hugs, and affections always reminded me that you knew I loved you, even though I couldn't always play with you. I love you very much. Keeson, my little baby, you are my biggest motivation of all in this journey. You are always motivating me in ways that I thought were only annoyances at that time. From the moment, the morning sickness, passing out, kicking in the ribs, to the sleepless nights, feelings of hopelessness and frustrations, you always seem to make me smile and keep me going. In closing, I would like to also thank God. I will never question things that happen in my life. They always have a way of making sense in the end. You know exactly what I mean. You are my rock. Granny, thank you for all of the things that you do for me. Even though I may not always show it, I do appreciate it. Mother, thank you for your knowledge about nursing. Even though you thought you weren't a big help, it always helped me. Also, thank you for always giving me words of encouragement to get through this. To my dad, thank you for never underestimating me. You never gave up on me. Cody Kirsch, thank you for taking care of us. You provided us with whatever you could. You encouraged me to be the best that I could be. Miss Sandy, I love your guts, and I will never forget you. Thank you for always caring. Thank you, Jesus. We are done. Barry LeMayer. First and foremost, I would like to thank the Lord above for giving me the strength, courage, knowledge, and the ability to get through the PN program. Second, I would like to thank my mother and father for their support and guidance through this time in my life. I would also like to thank my fiance for all those times I needed help studying. You are always there for me. Last, I would like to thank all of my classmates for all the laughs we have shared. It has been one wild ride with many highs and lows, but we have persevered through it all. Amanda Lucero. First, I would like to thank my loving and amazing husband, Patrick, for all of his love and support through this step in our lives. Thanks for the many days you have spent working away from home, missing out on many family get-togethers, hunting and fishing trips, and times together to support us through this these many months. Next, I would like to thank my mom, dad, and sisters for the love and support they gave when Patrick was not home, and I just wanted to give up. I would also like to thank the rest of my family for the support as well. Without you all, I would not have made it. Thanks to Miss Sandy, Miss Sandra, Miss Renita for teaching us the things we needed to know and giving us the little extra push we needed when things get tough. Last but not least, my cousin Buck. I know you were there watching over me when I felt like I couldn't do it anymore and just wanted to give up. But I knew you would be proud of me when I finished. And I did it. Congratulations, Class 47. We finally made it. Shayla Mott. Thank you, Lord, for helping me get this far. The countless prayers, sleepless nights, early mornings, and lots of studying have finally paid off. To my family, thank you for not only supporting me emotionally, but financially as well. Special thanks to my dad, who worked a lot of overtime to support me these last 18 months. To Jake, whom I always call my number one supporter, thank you for standing by my side, giving me confidence and motivation to finish this program. Thank you, Miss Sandy, Miss Mom, Miss Renita, for your patience and wisdom, and also for making this experience the best it could be. To my classmates, we have seen each other at our best and our worst. We learned things we never thought we were capable of, and we overcame boundaries that seemed impossible. Thank you for leaving me the memories that I will always cherish. Wherever life may take us, we will be great nurses and will make a difference in each patient's life. I would like to end with the quote, "It is simple yet meaningful." And as nurses, we must always remember this when we are taking care of patients. To the world, you might be one person, but to one person, you might be the world. Congratulations, everyone. Tracy Matthews. First, I give all the praise and honor to God. With Him, this wouldn't be possible. Lord, I thank you for continuously guiding my footsteps and giving me the strength and courage I needed to continue to follow my dreams. To my parents, my brothers, grandma, and Aunt Allison, I can't explain how much y'all mean to me for seeing more in me than I did in myself. Thanks for believing in me and strengthening me, especially the times when I was weak. I am truly grateful for that, and God has placed me in this loving and praying family. Thanks for all the prayers, encouraging words, love, support that y'all gave me. To the rest of my family and friends, thanks for the love and support that was shown to me. I really appreciate it. To my instructors, thanks for instilling wisdom and knowledge to make me get through this program. To my classmates, we have made it through and have many experiences together. Quilla and Karen, thank y'all so much for encouraging me to continue on when I was ready to quit. Congratulations to us all. I pray that we all fulfill our lifelong dreams as we start our journey. Candace Plaisons. I would first like to thank God for guiding me through my journey, for hearing my prayers and blessing me with this amazing opportunity. Through Christ, all things are possible. A special thanks to my biggest motivation, my mother, who is looking down on me from heaven as I stand here today. I pray that I have made her proud of my accomplishments. I would like to thank my amazing husband, Derek, for his love and support, financially and emotionally. If it weren't for him, I would have not started this journey. Also for all those late night study sessions and for putting his life on hold so that I could learn to help others. Words can't begin to explain how blessed I am to have him in my life. We have hit many bumps in the road, but always seem to find a way to make it through together. To my in-laws, thanks for your love, support, and many dinners on nights I was too deep in a book to cook. To my dad, thank you for your unconditional love, always believing in me and being there for me, especially for always being quick to fix my car so that I could get to clinicals on time. To my instructors, thank you for your wisdom, knowledge, and skills that I shall bring with me as I move further into my nursing career. To my classmates, thanks for the laughs and motivation to keep our heads held high through the tough times. I was so blessed to get to know each of you, and I will take a little something from all of you, your great personalities. Making it this far has not been the easiest task in our lives, but it showed us that with a little perseverance, we can succeed. I want to wish all of you a successful career as being the best nurses I know you can each be. Congratulations, we made it. Shana Roche. I would like to start off by thanking God, Mom, and Dad. Without either of you, I would not be the strong person I am today. You both have been there through every heartache and happy moments in my life, and I couldn't ask for better parents. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for pushing me every step of my life. My brother, who is growing up to be a handsome man, who I am very proud of. To Mia and Nini, thank you for inspiring me to follow in your footsteps and become a nurse. It is a truly great feeling to help people. Grandma Connie, thank you for being the grandparent I needed and always helping me and Dale out. After losing my grandfather, I needed your support and you never failed me. Last but not least, we have been through so much together. You are my backbone. From staying up late with me while I studied, getting up at 4 o'clock to put my uniform in the dryer, to listening to me complaining, I couldn't ask for a better other half. One step in our life together is complete and many more to come. Thanks again to all my family and friends for supporting my dreams. Shantilla Rito. First, I would like to thank God, the Almighty, for opening the doors for me and making the impossible possible. He said, speak things that are not as though they were. And I did, and he brought it to pass. To my parents, there are no words to describe how grateful I am for everything that you have done for me. To my mom, thanks for putting your life on hold to see my life go forward. To my grandmother, thanks for the help with the kids and the encouragement. To Avante and Aiden, thanks for being my motivation. To everyone in my family that I didn't name, thanks for all the support. I never would have made it. To my classmates, we made it. Good luck on the next journey that lies ahead. To my instructors, Miss Sandy, Miss Mock, Miss Renita, thanks for the patience and wisdom. To Karen and Tracy, thanks for the words of encouragement and a listening ear. Good luck on what lies ahead. Kelly Soon. I would like first to thank the four most important people in my life, my children, Wilton, Lauren, Callie, and Jax. You have been through so much this last year and a half, and I am so proud of all of you. Thank you for your patience and understanding throughout this ordeal. I'm sorry I couldn't always be the one driving you to school or bringing you to the places you needed to go, and that things have been a little tight here and there, but I know it would pay off in the end. I love each of you very much, and I am so proud to be your mom. To my mom, thank you for the support financially, as well as morally and emotionally. You are always there when I need you and wouldn't have survived without you. We are so grateful to you, and I would definitely repay the favor, all of them. Charlie, thanks for playing chauffeur. I don't know how my kids would have made it anywhere without you. You have become very important to me, and I am so glad we crossed each other's path. I love you. My teachers, Miss Cindy, Miss Sandra, Miss Renita, Miss Sandy, thanks for pushing me in the right direction and helping me to realize my own potential. My classmates, good luck to all of you. You all will make great nurses, I know. This has been a long and hard journey for me, and there are so many people in my life that I have been able to count on and have helped me and my children. It is very much appreciated. As Miss Sandy would say, it's done. Corey Strader. First, I would like to thank the good Lord above for giving me the ability and strength to complete this program, because without you, I know I would not be here this evening. Second, I would like to thank my wonderful family for being by my side during this rough road. Even though I may not have been able to see you all as much as I would have liked between working and studying, know that you were on my mind. I thank you for all the love and encouragement you have given me to this point. Next, I would like to thank the Ryborgs, my second family, for never ceasing to come to my rescue in this crazy life of mine. I don't know what I'd do without you guys. Y'all have always been there for me when you didn't have to be. I am so grateful to have all of you in my life. Thank you to Mr. Mail and Miss Betty for supporting me when it was difficult. I can't tell you how much it meant to me, and y'all will always have a special place in my heart. I am extremely blessed to have such wonderful people in my life. I love you all so much. Big thanks to my instructors, Miss Cindy, Miss Nail, Miss Sandy, Miss Mark, Miss Renita. Thank you for all believing in me when I wanted to give up on myself. I honestly cannot thank you all enough for being such great mentors in my life. I have learned so much from each of you. Lastly, I would like to thank my fellow classmates for tolerating my breakdowns and mood swings. But most of all, thank you for being by my side when I needed you most. We all may not have been able to agree on everything, but when it came down to it, we were there for one another. This has been quite a journey in such a short time. I will never forget our many laughs, cries, and interesting discussions during lectures. I am blessed that I was able to share this time with you guys, and I wish you all the best in what your futures have in store. First of all, I would like to thank my friend Valerie. Without you pushing me to enroll in a program, I would not even be here today. I would also like to thank my family for being by my side for the past 18 months. To my fiance, Caleb, as you know, living with a nursing student can be a stressful time. so I want to thank you for your patience and understanding. To my dad, I couldn't have made it without your love and support. You stood by me when I needed you the most, and I am grateful to have you as my father. Thank you to my sisters, Erin and Paige, for being there when I needed advice or just someone to listen. To my mother-in-law, Kaylin, thank you for your encouraging words. Having been in my shoes, you always seem to know what I needed. I would like to give a special thank you to Mrs. Bessie and Richard. You took on the roles of parents, teachers, and friends to my children, and I am truly grateful for you both. To my children, Tyson, Kobe, and Carly, I am sorry for the time I missed with you, but we can start making it up now. To my instructors, Miss Sandy, Miss Renita, Miss Monk, and Miss Cindy, thank you for seeing the good in me and pushing me to step up and follow through until I reached my goal. To my classmates, I am so glad to have had the chance to get to know you all. I am proud of each and every one of you. Congratulations.
Award, and it's the Angel Award to one of the students. This award was chosen by the students themselves for the person who exhibited compassion, integrity, and dedication on the clinical floor. Someone who was always ready to help their fellow student and never complained. And the Angel Award, this is a surprise. The Angel Award goes to Barry LeMaire.
Practical Nurses Pledge. If you're a nurse, please rise. As practical nurses, we do solemnly pledge to give good nursing care to the best of our ability, faithfully upholding the standards of our vocation. We will always regard the patient's race, nationality, and religious beliefs with sincerity and purity of heart. We will always give our full cooperation to those in the medical fields with patience and willingness. We will carry our lighter candles from patient to patient through year to year, faithfully fulfilling our duties and obligations as practical nurses.
Class 47, would like to give a special thank you to our instructors, Ms. Sandy Bollinger and Ms. Renita Levay. Without the two of you, we wouldn't be at this point. You have both been a shoulder to lean on and cry on, not only teaching us, but also letting us vent about our issues with school and life in general. Ms. Sandy, I'm sure the whole class agrees you were tough and to the point, and without that, we would have been lost. You know exactly what to say and when to say it, and we are thankful for everything you have taught us. We know we learn from the best. Mr. Neat, your words of encouragement have helped us so many, have helped so many of us get through the day and even through this. Though you came and taught our program a little late, we could not have done it without you. We will always remember you both and will do our best to be the great nurses you have taught us to be. Thank you.
Although we started this journey together, we are not ending this journey as we began. Unfortunately, during this course of the program, we lost a dear classmate and friend, Joel Tooting Capon. Joel was like no other. He was funny, confident, and everyone's friend. Even though he was known for his sense of humor and love for life, he was always eager to help us all and be the first to get his hands dirty during clinicals. Although he was only with us for a short time, he made a lasting impression on us all. So on behalf of Class 47 and instructors, we would like to present this plaque to Joel's family. He will always be remembered.
I would like to thank you all for coming tonight and participating with this joyous occasion. We will have cake and punch in the old gym. I think it's like to your right there. So we appreciate you coming. And before we have the march of the students out, I'd like for you to stand for a closing prayer with Jared.
Father, once again, we thank you for this amazing journey that you brought each and one of these students and helped them, God, to graduate and to be the nurses that you've called them to be. We just pray, God, that you will lead them every step of the way, God. Bless them and bless them indeed. Pray that you widen their territory, God. Keep their hands from evil and bless them. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. God bless you all.